Today's our topic is quotient rule for derivative. How we can apply a derivative when we have a function in f over g form. In previous video, we learned about how to apply a derivative on product rule, that we have a function in f of x and g of x. So this is product function and this is quotient term. How to apply a derivative when we have a function in f over g form? So it is very easy to apply the derivative by applying this formula on it. But if we have a f over g form, which is a quotient term, and applying the derivative, so what we do to apply the derivative on this term? Simply, the term which is in denominator, write this term and multiply with the derivative of the upper term which is in numerator, minus. So keep in mind that the sign between them is minus. Then upper function, upper term is simply write, multiply derivative of the term which is in the denominator. Then this whole factor can be divided by the term which is in the denominator square. So the square of the term which is in denominator. So simply this is the formula to apply on the quotient rule. So let us take examples to understand and to apply this rule on questions and which type of questions. So let us take it. We have a divide form, yeah, quotient form. So how to apply a derivative on this term according to this formula? So let's suppose that this is f of x and this is g of x, just for comparison to applying this formula on it. So applying derivative dh over dx, then according to this formula, quotient rule formula, is the term which is in denominator, simply write it x square plus 1. Derivative of the upper term, which is applying power rule, which is 2 the power bahir x 3 minus 1, which is 2, minus 2, again applying power rule, 2x, or derivative of any constant term is 0. Then sign is minus. Simply write the upper term, the term which is in denominator, 2x cube minus 2x square plus 7, and derivative of the term which is in the denominator, g of x. So applying again power rule, 2x, and the derivative of any constant term is 0, and divide the whole factor with the square of the term which is in denominator, x square plus 1 ka square, which is equals to x square plus 1 into 6x square minus 4x. The sign is minus, and 2x into 2x cube minus 2x square plus 7, and divided by x square plus 1 square, which is dy over dx. So multiply these two terms, so dy over dx, which is equals to 6x ki power 4 minus 4x cube plus 6x square minus 4x. The sign is minus, then multiply these two terms, 4x ki power 4 minus 4x cube plus 14x, divided by x square plus 1 square. The next step is to open the minus, 6x ki 4 minus 4x cube plus 6x square minus 4x minus 4x 4 minus 4x cube plus 14x, divided by x square plus 1 square. Then simplify these terms. 6 minus 4, which is 2x4 plus 6x square minus 18x divided by x square plus 1 square. 2x common, x cube plus 3x minus 9 divided by x square plus 1 square. And this is final answer. Find derivative dy over dx. Let's suppose this is f of x, this is g of x. Just for comparison, to apply this formula on it. If you remember this formula, then there is no need to say that this is f of x, this is g of x. So using this formula, the term which is in denominator, right, sine of x multiply derivative of the upper term, which is 5x square. So by the power rule, 5 into 2x. The sign is minus. The upper term as it is, which is 5x square, and derivative of the term which is in the denominator. And the derivative of the sin x is cos x. So cos of x divided by the term which is in denominator is in square. So sin of x square. This is very important step, because in this step we apply formula. Okay, so 10x into sine of x minus 5x square cos of x divided by sine square of x, and this is the final answer of this question.